and killed her to King's Cross. It's 13 hours on a bus. I press my face against the glass and watch the white lines rushing past. And all around me felt like all inside me, and my body left me, and my soul went running. Have you ever seen King's Cross? When the rain is falling soft, I came in on the evening bus from Oxford Street. I cut across, and if the rain don't fall too hard, everything shines just like a postcard. Everything goes on just the same. Fair weather friends are the hungriest friends. I'd keep my mouth well shut, I'd cross with open hands. I wanna see the sun go down from St. Kilda Esplanade, where the beach needs reconstruction, where the palm trees have it high. I give you all of Sydney Harbour, all that land and all that water for that one sweet promenade. I give you all of Sydney Harbour, all that land and all that water for that one sweet promenade.
Botanical Garden. We're on a tour. And there's I'm not sure what this greenhouse looking thing is. Back there was a rose garden. And that's the admin building back there. I'm not sure what it is. We're going in to see an unusual flower in this building.
We'll come closer.
So we'll see how the transition is from daylight to inside. Not bad.
Stinky plant.
Yeah. Stinkus plantus.
Stage for a number of years, so it'll send up one leaf and then it'll die back It'll put its energy back into the corm, which forms down here, until it gets to a size large enough to sustain the flower. And then the flower will come up. That may take 5 to 10, 15 years to get to that stage. These ones are grown by a particularly talented horticulturalist at our Mount Lofty Gardens. And he can get them to flower in about 3 years. He's becoming quite a world expert in it. He has taken leaf cuttings and has around 100 smaller plants started from that. And it's a critically endangered plant, and so it's, you know, it's great conservation work that he's doing there. This one was set to flower. You can see the growth rate there, and it was growing really rapidly. So this is when it was at Mount Lofty. And then they brought it here around about year, and then we had cold weather and it stopped. And so all the publicity stopped about it. It may not even open yet. Yeah, and it's holding like that. I mean, I was here almost 2 weeks ago and it was like this. So it's a bit shorter. But,
I've been looking at the website to find out when it's flowering.
Yeah, I think it's been since this
year. Once it's flowered, cold.
This is 50 years old, this tree. Only grown in Australia.
Gardens are placed around the botanic gardens so that people can see and live here what you can do on the rainfall that we have.
Do you think more people are getting into succulents?
Yeah.
I used to hate them, but now I'm
a
avid fan.
Very
fashionable.
This is a water collection system. I guess when it rains, it runs down here and it goes through some filtration and is pumped underground, and they're going to have 130 megaliters of water in the reservoir. Then they'll use that to irrigate the whole garden. And they have to, they get all the salts and it's extremely pure water.
Facilities on board, and they were ready to call them all into Port Adelaide because we were out of water. And the Murray River was going to be stopped at Table Bend, and they were going to abandon the lower lakes and just let them acidify.
Yeah, so
in the rain shadow, Swan Reach, anywhere along the river there, it's pretty stuck into this sort of territory. A lot of the land between here and New South Wales and Victoria is like this. It's fairly difficult to work.
everybody join. This guy likes to chase everything.
So this is about 3 hours north of Auckland. And that's the tree. And it's me there.
Oh, that's my
God. So this one's estimated to be about 2,500 years old. Yeah.
This one is about 2 meters in diameter, and our guide said that he saw one that was 4 meters in diameter. It was roughly 2,000 years old.